Okay, there we go. Welcome back, everybody. I moved my coffee off the table. Coffee and art in the morning. Thanks, everybody, for being here. We're going into a part two. I said that I would either finish up the look page from last week or work in my abandoned places or in my mixed media collage journal. This is my altered book. This is my altered journal, collage mixed media journal. So, this was the votes for this one. So I will finish the look page probably on Wednesday, because I don't know how long this, you know, will work on this. It's the same process. I'll start this by saying, this is the same. Yes, we are shopping queens for sure, Miss Aroma. And good morning, by the way. I work in a couple of different altered books, Forgotten Heritage and Abandoned Places. And then I also work in mixed media. It's the same process, but I'm starting with a blank page. Let me find a blank page. I start with a blank page in this one, where in Abandoned Places, we start with a page that's already been, it's got something on it, and we're kind of reverse collaging it out. I use the same products. I use Americana Craft Paint. I use Golden Matte Medium for gluing. I use Delta Ceram Coat Interior Exterior Gloss Varnish when I varnish the pages. And so it's all the same products. And let me go ahead and say this too. I do have a video, I think it's under Art Supplies, where I list all the stuff I use. It's the same stuff I always use. And I know I always get the same questions. Well, what varnish are you using? What painter are you using? It's all the same. Now, of course, occasionally I'll throw in a white Posca pen or a pencil, probably a Prisma. You know, I throw in some other little mixed media things. But for the most part, it's Americana Craft Paint, collage things that I find from calendars, old books, and or things like that, and then my matte golden matte medium for the glue. Sometimes if I add another little glue something at the, you know, if I miss something, I'll just go in here with my tacky glue and just glue something on top if I miss something like that. But yeah, so I'm going to do a little peruse, and then we'll start working. I think, let me show you this one first. So in this one, and again, it's the Diane Reevely. I don't have a blank one to show you because I've painted this out. It has a red spine when it's new, and it's kind of a craft color. Yes, I'm going to be working in Abandoned Places, Beth. It's got like a craft color cover, which I've painted, and the front and the back, and it's been varnished. And so this is what my collages look like. I call them mixed media collage because it's paint, it's collage, it's a little bit of, you know, paint and collage, mixed media collage. So let me tell you a couple more tips. If you're working in a book like this with the spine, and I'd say this with the magazine journals, with all the journals, it's best if you don't work like from front to back, like page one, page two, because you're going to warp the spine. The spine will start to, let me show you on one of my magazine journals. I keep it handy because it's such a good example. In a magazine, this is two magazines glued together and with mixed media collage in it. This is, see what happens right there? When you go front to back, see how that spine is almost vertical there? Well, horizontal this, or vertical, yeah, anyway. The spine is completely warped, and that's because going through it from front to back, your spine will warp, and there's no getting that back. Once it's warped in whatever journal or magazine journal, any kind of journal, you can't undo that. But if you don't want that to happen, then you work all through the book, some in the front, some in the back, back and forth. And it doesn't guarantee, but it will help not to start to, see, it's starting to warp a little, but you see how I've got more in the front than in the back? So technically I need to work more in the back so that that happens less. So I have a few pages done in here, and some are varnished and some are not. If you If you want to use varnish on your pages, whether it's this or an art card, I got a couple art cards here because I'm sending out a couple. These are my art cards that I make on stream and send out. It's all the exact same process. But if you want to varnish them, you have to make sure that you don't have watercolor, neocolors, anything. Is that the same for fibs? I missed something, Bunny. I'm sorry. You may or may not be talking to me. When it's in caps, guys, I assume you're talking to me. So I missed something. Sorry, Bunny. You want to make sure that you don't have any water soluble, reconstitutable water products like neocolors, watercolor, because when you go to put the varnish on it, you're going to smear it. However, if you are a spray fixative person, go outside, spray it down, you know, and all that. I do not like spray fixatives. I just don't. They always smell afterward to me, no matter how long. I can still smell the fixative on old drawings I've done and stuff. I just don't care for it. So, yeah. So I try to keep this all to my craft paint. Hey, Kathy Kaberg. And I like my Americana craft paint, which now is behind me, so I have to keep jumping up. Good exercise. I like my Americana craft paints. You can get them for like a dollar or so. Come in so many colors, and they're really, they're nice and, they have good coverage. But any craft paint will do. I'll say this, if you plan on putting any kind of pencil work over your acrylic paint, I think she meant once it's warped that you can't fix it. I got it, Button. Okay, so she meant once it's warped, you can't fix it. Same for like the friends in the box. Okay, got it. I try to keep up, but I am jumping up and down a lot, guys, so sometimes I do miss some things. Thank you, Button. don't use gloss or satin paint if you plan on putting color pencil over it. That's why I like using this in color books. If I do washes in my color books, that it is just Americana craft paint or any kind of craft paint that's not satin or gloss, because then you can't pencil over it. It's the shine, and that's true of the like your artist grade paints that have a sheen to them. Oh, thanks everybody for being here. Got 140 something people here. Thanks, Vicky. I didn't even notice. Thank you guys for being here. If I miss saying good morning to you, thanks for being here. But anyway, the artist grade has a sheen to it in their binder. You like that? You like that word, Marilyn? Reconstitutable. But acrylic paints are not. You can't get, once they're dry, they're dry. So you can varnish over them, right? So yeah. So I try to work, like here's a page where I've just started. Okay, and some of this isn't even glued down yet. It's just tacked down. If I go through a page and I think, oh, this needs a little bit more something, something, and I don't have my my golden matte medium out. Here's my golden. This is what golden matte medium is. Okay, it's not gel. It's not matte gel. It's not gel anything. It's in a jar and it's liquidy and it's called matte medium. Because I know people ask me all the time, which one is it? This is what it is. But if I just want to tack something down for a temporarily, I'll just use a Yoohoo glue stick and you know, just put a little swipe of glue on it and just stick it where I know I'm going to want to eventually glue it all down. All right, so I'm just kind of giving a little review here. So you can see, look, see, I have, can you imagine this little bit right here? So I did some gluing in over the weekend while I was watching, who was I watching? Paula? Yeah, I was watching Paula on Saturday, Sunday? Anyway, I was watching Paula, and while I was watching her, I was adding some more bits to my collage, mixed media collage, this one and my abandoned places. So they're ready to go for some more, like here. See how I've added, just tacked them down for a minute. And then I'll glue them down with matte medium. and then I'll paint over them to make the worlds, which we'll see. Here's another one that I took apart and started. This was one of the calendars. This was that Left Behind calendar that has all kind of abandoned items in it. This one here. So I tore out everything out of it, tore every bit of it out, and used every bit of it. I think I used all but one little sliver of everything out of this. Where's that? Oh, here. So this is that house right here. It's in a yard and all kinds of things, you know, trees and stuff going around it. Well, this is what I did with it. I cut it, fussy cut out the big bus page. I know, someone's going to think, I like big buses, and I can't. I know you girls. And then some of the stars from the Hubble telescope calendar. So you can see, here's the windmill. I just tacked it down because I don't know what else I want to do on this page yet. But I'm just going to kind of flip through. And if you want to go on a spine, it's best if you cut it and glue it separate and then paint that in. If you try to just fold your page and glue it right over the fold, it's going to end up tearing in the middle anyway. So you might as well just paint it in. So these are all just pages in process. I've been working more in my altered book than I have been in the journal. But it's the same process. Matte medium is no sheen. Yeah, that's why it's called matte. You can get a gloss medium, and that's shiny. But I just use the matte medium. It makes everything flat and matte, and that's also what I like to do in my books that are shiny. And then after it's all said and done, this is the varnish that I use. The Delta Ceram Coat Gloss Exterior Interior Varnish. Yeah, the reason, if you split them like that, then they're not going to, you can still, the paint can still eventually, you know, crack or break, but it doesn't happen very often. I mean, I don't go through these, I do go through the books a lot, but it's not like they're getting looked at 24/7, you know what I mean. So here's one that I started. See where I cut the page right there? I'll paint that in. And yeah, this bit was over here on the calendar. I cut it apart, and I'll make my own worlds. Yeah, so I'm going to make my own worlds with this. Okay, this is a boat. It's upside down. I put it, always look at your images right side up, upside down. So this is a half of a boat, and I turned it upside down, and I'm going to make it look like it's in the water. This was a different thing, see? So you can, this is where I cut out a moon. And so I use the negative space, and I'll put something else in here. So you can see. This one's done here, and see, I've got it varnished and everything. Hopefully it's not too flashed out. And I know I show these all the time, but every time I do the, welcome back, Jean. Every time I do something in the book, I like to just do a little flip so that people understand where we're heading. So this is where we go. This just started out with, these are marbles that I use for planets. There's a big watch part there. I love adding the element of time. I like water, space, mist, fog. I like this, a lot of the same elements. I just like making my worlds like that. This is all paint. There's a bit of a leaf thing here. And it's just all different collage bits. It starts, they all start out like this. This is what they start out as. And then we, yes, Brave New Worlds. And then we go from this and turn it into these, like this. But they all start like this. And sometimes when I start the show, I'll start with the page I've already got done. Or sometimes we start from scratch. But that takes a long time. Jean did some awesome watercolor marbles. And I should have got pictures of these. Well, you can get them online. Jean did an awesome watercolor marble page. So this is what they start with, but it does take time to, when I sit here and go through all my collage bits, I have a box and drawers full of collage bits, books and all kinds of calendars and things. And it takes a while to select And so that's what I was doing on while I was watching Paula. I was going through and selecting more collage bits and just tacking them on with a Yoo-hoo stick. And then now I can go back and glue things down and paint them in. Here's another one that's finished. And again, you can see I have varnished it. I haven't varnished all my finished pages, especially in my Abandoned Places book. I've not varnished a lot of them yet, but I do want to varnish them. Okay, so there's this one. You can see the little underground caverns there and all the... And there's actually, that's not white there. That's actually the shine from the varnish right in the crack there. But so this is what they start out as. Just going to quickly flip. Here's another finished one. And my art cards, my postcards, they're all made, the posters, y'all see me, I'm still working on that big poster. I've got some big posters in the works. It's all done exactly the same way. All done the exact same way. Bye, Melody. Rest that hand. I hope it's healing. All right, let's see. There's one in process. Again, I'm trying to go through. Here's one. Now, I don't like this one. This is one of the few that I've done I really don't like. And this one did tear. I didn't let the varnish dry enough before I closed the book. So I do have a tear in this one. You have to let the varnish dry. I try to let it dry overnight before I close the book. But I've never had any sticking. I've never had any sticking with my Golden Matte Medium or my Delta Ceram Coat varnish. Like some other products, you might have sticking with your pages, your art journal pages. But this case, I did not let it dry. It got some varnish was still in the crack there, and so I do need to repaint that. This one, though, the vision did not come to fruition like I had imagined. This fish popping out toward you through the water, I didn't accomplish it in the look that I wanted it to. So to me, this is a fail. I mean, a lot of people like it, but I just don't like the way I need the water to come this way. The water's just going this way, and the water needs to come this way. So that's just not one of my favorites. So here's some more pages in process. I think here's another one in process. So you can see, this is like, look at, this is a flower. Here's an upside down trail, a tram car or some kind of a roller coaster or something. But it's going to go into this. This looks like, doesn't it look like a little cave thing, you know, a little door. See, look, I like to do my little. Yeah, I don't use that, Pat, for sure. Okay, so this is what this book looks like. Again, I've varnished and done both the covers on this one. There's my little monk guy way down there next to this huge statue foot. And then there's the cover. And this is just one of those, you know, ones with the thing there. And then the inside cover, I've done that too. I know y'all recognize the book, what it looks like. So, and I've got, I don't know, I think I got four of these ongoing, four of these. And then I have two of my Abandoned Places. But first, a little rabbit trail. So Carol Renee, and I knew it was either her or Suzanne, Carol Renee sent me the Color My Sketchbook Wild. So when I do the... the fail club. Well, you know, and that's kind of the thing. It's like Jean. I use Jean as an example, too. And she's the first to use her example, too, when she was trying to do her watercolor Stone Angel. It just was a fail. So, but look how you can learn a lot from the fails. Because, especially if we leave them up and share them. Because then you know what not to do. You know, if everything always works out, then you don't know what to do when something doesn't work out. Stoned Angel. Yeah, Jean. So I will do a flip through this when we go to do the color book on Wednesday. I want to finish the look page that we did last week. I want to finish that. And then I'll show this and probably do a page out of this as well. I'm sure you can find flips of this online. This is the Bennett Klein Wild. So thank you, Carol Renee. We'll be working in that next, probably Wednesday. Along with the look. We'll finish the look first, and then we'll probably do a page in the wild. So we're going to do that. The other, only other thing I want to show y'all that I got this weekend was I got the Wizard of Oz one. Now, if this had been full price, I would not have probably have bought it. But it was at Books A Million. It was on sale for $7.97. So I had to get it, right? I had to get it for $7.97. Someone else help me out here, please. I couldn't resist it for that. And then when I bought it, there was a teacher working the register. She says she teaches fourth graders. And she goes, oh, where did you find that for $7.97? I told her where it was in the clearance department because she is doing a Wizard of Oz themed project with her fourth graders. And she wanted to know because she wanted to go get it. I know, right? So, I will show this one when I do the color books on Wednesday. We'll do another color book page. You bought it online and printed it on thicker paper. Yeah, this paper, it's a little, it's not as thin as copy paper, but it's not much thicker. Bunny says she bought this and printed it out herself. So it's got the story on one side and then the pictures on the other. So every page has got a piece of the story. Like, so you can see it's a lot of text to, and when I do text, I like to do the ombre effect. So that even takes longer. But I will show this on Wednesday as well. So we'll, when we do a color book day. Oh, yeah, Wednesday. Okay, so now into the abandoned places, and I keep this here, guys, because I want everybody to smile, but also because it is a camera focus, thingy. So in abandoned places, it would have been rude not to at that price. That's right, Miss Aroma. It was my duty, Samurai said, to buy it. Oh, the Wild. Oh, you bought the Wild. Okay, so Bunny says she bought the Wild and printed it on. Yeah, this is probably some of the thinnest paper you're going to find in a color book. But it's they're also, you can get these for under $10, you know. So it's a great buy. And, you know, if you don't like the thin paper, which is it's one-sided, so it doesn't even really matter if it goes through. But you just put it on some cardstock. Right? Okay, so we'll look at those on Wednesday. So in my abandoned places, again, during Paula's show, I went through and added some more things. I do have quite a bit done in this book. I don't have as much done in the Forgotten Heritage book. I'm working in two different altered books. So here's one that is done and varnished. So a lot of the pages that I do have finished in here are not yet varnished. Because when I varnish them, I have to leave them open overnight. So, you know, sometimes I just don't have enough nights to do that. But this is one, and it's kind of what I kind of call a reverse collage. And I'm going to do a little bit of that. I'll do a couple pages where I'm like going from a blank page and showing you, you know. So what you do is you paint out. You can see it here. You paint out areas, and then you can collage on them, and then paint stories into them. So I'm going to do a quick flip. I know I've done a flip in this one just like last week, but I'm going to do it again real quick. So like this, this is all added here. The water is added. So you just kind of paint out and then paint back in. Just have that darker one on your list. Yeah, the dark, yeah, the Bennett Klein dark, yeah. So again, this was already here, but I painted in some sky, added my own planets, and then painted my own clouds over the top. And this is all just craft paint. It's all just craft paint, mostly Americana. I'd say 99.9% Americana. I use an occasional flesh tone from another brand or something, but Americana craft paints. Okay, no, they don't sponsor me or anything. They could if they wanted to, but they don't. So again, here's where this is out of the house, one of the abandoned, the left behind. Let me see here. This calendar here. Yeah. So this little house right here, I fussy cut out, and here we go. Hi and bye, Fancy Lime. I'm sorry I missed you. Anybody else coming in? If I miss saying good morning to you, I'm sure I've missed a lot of people. Let's see, TNT. I'm just going to do a quick. I said hi to Queen Pam and Q-Bev, Nat, Norwegian Girl. I'm just really scrolling real fast. I try to say, hey, Paula. I try to say good morning to everybody before I hit record. And speaking of Paula, the Dilusions Journal. Thank you, Paula. I could not think of the name for nothing. This is my Dilusions Journal. Thank you, Paula. And Paula, by the way, if you're not working today, Janet cannot stream today. So if you want to stream after me, let us all know if that's a possibility for you. We want to see those watercolors. Paula. We want to see those watercolors. So if you want to stream after I get done, tell the girls. So you can see, and I just tacked it down. This is what I did while I was watching Paula on Sunday. I went through, fussy cut out some things out of my calendars or tore them out, and then just tacked them down real quick where I wanted them, because I didn't want to. The thing about when you use your matte medium and glue things down, you got to hit it with the heat gun and dry every page. Obviously, you can't, turn the page until it's dry. Which that's what you do as you're working a page. I'm just waiting to see what Paula says. So here's one. This one is done. I might add a couple stars. Like down here, I think I want... Let me get a Posca to show you. I think I want one reflection down here. And then this one will be ready to varnish. So I want to put a little star here. And then when that's dry, I can take my pencil. You have to be careful when you use color pencils if you're going to varnish. So if you do use any color pencils, and you work 3 to 11 tonight, but off the next 2 days. Okay. Okay, Paula. So that means you don't have time to stream? Is that what you're trying to tell us? I can just work for, a little bit, Paula, and you can take over. We like to accommodate you because of your odd schedule. So let me know. Let me know if you want to stream this morning. So got to make sure. See, I didn't let's not dry. So let me hit that with the heat gun, which is right here. And then I can take my pencil and do more like light dusting of a glow or something. But the thing about using the pencil, like I was saying, is when you go to varnish this, you can't be rubbing a lot on this with the varnish. When I put my varnish on, I put it on with a sponge brush. And if it's an art card, I'll use my finger. But if it's something this big, I use a sponge brush because it won't leave brush marks. Let me reach up here. I just use a sponge brush to put the varnish on. But you have to be a little careful where you have pencil, because the pencil can lift up, especially if you're just doing it real lightly like that, say. Okay, like that. So this one's ready to varnish. This one I'm considering done and is ready to varnish too. Painted this through here. There were reflections on the floor. Well, I should say I do want to kind of crisp up the edges of this window reflection. But other than that, this one will be ready to varnish too. Hey, Jen. Anybody else I miss? Thanks, everybody, for being here. Hey, Abby. Yeah. Well, I'm waiting to see if she can squeeze it in. I'm waiting. If she can squeeze it in, that's awesome. Because we know she doesn't get much chance to stream. This one is, this, all this right here is just part of the book. But I added torn bits of stars and formed into mountains in the background. Again, not done. You can, you know, they're all, in, this is all a book in process. I will work on one page for a little bit, go around to another page, work on it for a while. So I'm back and forth. So here we added a little marble here, a little planet here, and then some painted, I painted the sky and painted the clouds. And this was a four, like there's a, some pictures here where they have four pictures on one. Let's see if I can find one. They have four photographs on one picture. So what I've done, though, is tried to make it like two worlds. So here's our upper level world, and then here's our lower level world, and I'm trying to blend them all together because there are four separate individual photographs that didn't have anything to do with each other. So I'm trying to make them all cohesive. Thanks, and hi, Leah, by the way. And then, so you can see, I've done some waterfalls, a little river way in the back there, and it's not done, but I'm trying to, thanks. I'm not sure who Anonymous is. I'm cracking down on Anonymouses, guys. I hate to say that, but yeah. If you can at all possible sign in, please, if at all possible. So this one right here, I added a planet and, Anonymouses are usually not allowed to chat without being signed in. I'm just saying this for the Ustream viewers and the Ustreamers. Are usually not allowed to chat, but sometimes they can, and I don't like it. Just saying. I don't like anonymous chatters. I mean, I'm not trying to be mean or anything. I just would rather you sign in than be an anonymous person. If that's not too much trouble. Hey, WV. Thank you. Thank you for being here. That's okay. At least tell us who you are. At least give us a name so we know who you are. Thank you. So I'm just going to kind of scroll through here. This had a bunch of text on the sides. So I painted out the text. This one I'm working in little bits. This one we added the girl in the chair, and it's not done yet. I've added some star stuff going on up here. This is all paint. So here's an example of, you know, two different pictures on one page. I added a little bit of cutout here, and I'm going to CC. Thank you, CC. Thank you so much. Welcome. Did Paula ever answer if she wants to stream today? I still didn't get that. I might have scrolled off. I really want to know, because if Paula has a chance to stream, we want to give it to her. Because of her schedule, guys, she doesn't get to very often. So this is out of the abandoned or that left behind building thing. And so I cut this out. I cut this door out so it looks like this is going into that. And I will blend all this together. I almost feel like I want to work on this page. I might put a post-it note on this page. Yeah, I know. It does kind of, Vicky, look a little strange, doesn't it? So I might work on this page. I'll put a post-it note there. But I do want to show a couple places where I have nothing done on the page and where I paint things out. So I'm trying to give y'all at least, you know, how it looks so that you have something to, like, see where I'm going with it, right? Yes. This is one of my favorites. All this is paint. And I'm painting it to look like a watery mist. And then this is all paint here. And then the little stair banisters have little. Yes, I do. We want you to. But Paula, you know what you have to do though, right, Paula? You have to do the watercolor swatching. We want to see the wine. I do anyway. I don't know about everybody else. She got to show other things on her stream on Sunday, but I wanted to see the watercolor. So I think what we're going to do here, guys, is I'm going to, I'll probably work a little bit on this page, but I want to just show you how I can, how you can paint out a couple pages. Yeah, I know, right, Deborah? It's just fun to, like this right here, instead of having just this white sky with this text up here, this could be a total outer space scene. I know, I love this book too. I know. Aw, thanks, Diana. Paula, make sure and put your link in there so that when we finish up here, I'll make it a quick one because I want Paula, I want her to have every, she's our veteran streamer. She's the old streamer. Anytime that, and now with her schedule, she works nights, weekends, round the clock, 24 hours. She just doesn't, if there's any opportunity for her to stream, I like to give it to her. So, yeah. So you can see this is what this, I just cut this car out. See, this says ghost towns and cities. This is going to go on here and be a part of this world here. It's Journal Artista. If y'all, yeah, it's not hard to find Paula. Journal Artista, Pom. So this one right here is all outer space. I got rid of the sky. And what I want to do in here, though, is little people or little worlds. So you can go in here with, where's my Posca? That'll be the easiest thing to show. Where's my Posca? Oh, it's right here. So, like, for instance, in each one of these little worlds here, you could do a little, a little bit of stars and maybe a little bit of planet with a couple of colors. So it looks like you're looking through this abandoned building to outer space, which there's one like that in here I'm going to show you anyway. So you can do stuff like this in those little spaces. See? It's so fun, guys. And I also say, I like doing outer space and water themes and clocks and watches. But let's just say you like gardens or, beautiful houses and mansions with gardens. You can do the same type thing with themes or with books that you like. And it's really best if you do that. If you pick a book, like let's just say you do not like abandoned places. They creep you out or whatever. Then don't get this book to do this. Get a book with gardens. Get a book on any theme you like. Anything. If you like, your pets, like less dogs, cats, birds. Any book that you want to alter over a long period of time, you need to have a book you like. Because if you don't like the book, you're going to feel like it's a chore. Every time you open it, it's going to be a chore to work in it. So here, all this was here, and then all this has been painted out. Okay? So you can kind of see. Thanks, Bunny. Bunny, put your link in there, too. Bunny's going more coloring digitally because of her arthritis. She's going to be doing a lot more digital coloring. So if you are any person that likes Digi or wants to know about Digi coloring, Bunny, put your link in there for your stream. Now, she's in UK, and she does stream. For me, she comes on like a 3 in the morning. She comes on almost the middle of the night for some of us. But she does record, so you can always watch her recordings. Here's one with 4 pictures. So in something like this, you either have to just completely paint parts of it out or try to incorporate this into multiple worlds, right? See, look how cool these are. And I know I'm just kind of flipping, and so you can kind of see what it looks like before. Let me just, all right, I'm gonna use this one as an example to do paint out. Just so, all right, exactly, Mirar. If it's a chore, you want to have a book or, do projects that are going to be fun for you. So here's one that we've done here. I say we because if you guys are here and I'm working on it, it's we. But, So like this one, I might just want to get rid of all this and just make this a whole focal point. So you can't be afraid. You just got to go and paint it out. something stuck there. See, when I tacked this down, I got a little bit of glue there. Not that it matters because I painted it out anyway. But in this one, I want to do all stars down here. So I want this to look like it's on another dimension and then have the stars down here. See, here's another one where all the sky is. See, this is what's here first. I'm going to glue matte medium this down and paint it all into a cohesive world. So you can leave whatever you want, get rid of anything. This is added on. But look how it just kind of looks like it should go there, doesn't it? But this is all just wasn't there. But I'm going to make it there. This is going to be like a mountain, and this is going to be on top of the mountain. Again, just some little bits, you know, tacked in here. Here's an abandoned airplane. I'm putting it in this room. This was just a piece of white window, and I'm going to put stars in there. So you can just kind of see some of the process. I did all this while I was watching Paula's show on Sunday. All these little bits that are loose in here, I did all that on her show while I was watching her show. This, see? There's another half planet up there. This one, there's a video up. Now, this one is finished, but I haven't varnished it yet. But you can see we added a planet. All this is paint. All this is paint. All this is paint. Added my watches and planets. Those are some marbles. Hey, Sarah. Good to see you. This one's done. There's a video on it. Not varnished yet, but it's done. Someone suggested this could have been a sand dune, and that's so good. I wish they would have said that before I had done this, because I would have made this a sand dune. Right here, that would have been a sand dune. But yeah. So let me just kind of flip, because there's a few more pages that are done in here. Like this one, I'm going to add that up there, and this half planet down here. I want to kind of get through this quickly so we can do a little bit of paint. So you can kind of just see all the abandoned places. And it does, again, whether you use this one or a similar one or something completely different. So here's a planet here. Now, this was not a planet in like, you know, you can make your own planets. Find any kind of texture, any kind of design. It can be clouds, a cloudy day. And then just take you a ring like this. And just cut you out a bunch of circles. See? Make your own planets. You don't have to have an actual photograph of a planet. Okay. Let's flip. Here's some more where I've added some bits that I want to play with. This is one of the fun. This is done, but it's not varnished either. This was an abandoned building. And it had these people already in it, just standing there. So I blacked out everything else and made this into like they're looking down into space. I love the way this looks. So just a bunch of guys standing there. I think there's a girl there too. So all that's painted in down at the bottom. See, so it's like a floating space city. And then I painted inside the windows. I love this page. I love that page. So, see all the fun stuff? This is going to work like this. This is bits of outer space, a plant, half planet that's just stuck on there. See? This will be another world. Thanks, guys. Yeah, it's fun. This big planet, this moon, it's on top of a monorail or something. This is all going to be painted out. See, and look at the road. See the road right there? Okay, let's see. Do I have anything else? This one's done. Had an abandoned ship there. Painted all my water. And I don't really like these feathers on there, but I was just playing with the water spouting out. Look, reminded me of feathers, so I painted in some feathers. Painted in a moon. This one's in progress. Glued on, painted out the bars holding up this like old abandoned gas station. So yeah, so I'm gonna work for about 10-15 minutes, and then we're gonna go to Paula's. I'm sorry, I'm excited to go to Paula's. I want to see her watercolors. Is that terrible? This one's done. It's not varnished yet, but it's sorry, guys. You know, it's just one of those things. Thank you, Vicky. The fish coming in from space there with the clouds painted over it. This is an abandoned like rail station, and it's funny. One of my Facebook friend guys has a photograph of this actual. I think he said it was in New York. Abandoned railroad, and he has the actual photograph of this, so it's funny to see it, you know, like in change, and then the original, and then there's a back here we painted in the little where the the train would come, and a tiger, you know, and the water lilies, we put all that in there. Hey Jess, Pitbull Jess, thank you, thanks for being here. So this one, put the little stone angel here. She's touching the train. We put a little space thing in there. So this is all paint here. Yeah, she said she would. You like the one with the fish and the tiger? Thanks, Kathy. So again, this one, I have a deer waiting in the wings and some fog down there. This is all painted out. So yeah, you can kind of see where we're going. So I'm going to do a couple of examples. I'm going to take this one. Now I'm not going to finish. I just want to do this real quick, guys, so you can get the idea, okay? And I've shown you all the supplies and everything. So in this case, I have no collage on here yet. Now you can do it a couple ways. You can do some, glue the collage on and then paint. You can paint and then collage, or you can do a combination. You can do a combination of the two. Do a little bit of painting, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. So, and I would recommend, I'm not going to do it now because it's going to take an extra step of drying, so I'm not going to do this. But if you have a shiny book, it's easier to work on a matte. If you have coated your paper with matte, even though you're going to end up shining it with gloss, it's easier if you work on a solid matte surface. So if your page is glossy, I would recommend, and I do that most of the time, but not always, but I've done so many of them. I would recommend putting a coat of matte medium on it first and let it dry, and then go into your next steps. Or if you're going to collage stuff on at the beginning, then while you're gluing all this down, make sure you cover the whole thing with matte medium. And then go in and paint and add more stuff. I hope I'm making sense. Always take some wax paper and put behind your pages, whether you're painting or matte medium, so you don't want to glue your pages together. Don't ask me how I know that. But you don't want to glue your pages shut. So I'm going to put some behind there. Now what I'm going to do is, on this particular page, I'm not going to finish this one. I'm going to go to the other one. But I want to show you how you can just take a page. You're welcome, Scooby. Happy birthday again. If y'all didn't know, today's Scooby Girl's birthday. We all said hi, happy birthday to her earlier. So she's off to walk the dogs. Okay, so I'm going to look at this. I think I'm going to go with sienna because there's a little bit in there. I'm liking the sienna. I love my same colors. I hate to always use the same colors, but I have certain colors I love. So, I'm going to go with this and maybe some white. Okay, so I'm just going to show you real quick. On this page, I'm just going to show you how to, like, get rid of stuff. Okay? So I got some white. It's all Americana. White. I got some baby blue. I got some uniform blue, which this is almost out. I probably need a little add of water to it and get whatever I can out of that one. And then some persimmon, which is kind of like a russet orange. All right, so I think what I'm going to start with is I'm going to go ahead and do the background persimmon just because it's different. All right, so I'm going to just take The other thing, too, about having matte medium over everything rather than going from a slick surface, when you take your paint, and I'm not going to add any water to this. It's not a wash. It's straight out the jar, and it's not watered down at all. Okay? It's just straight out of the jar. The thing about having this, if I had painted this with the matte medium, it's going to have more tooth, and it'll be easier to cover than just going straight in with paint on a slick paper, you see. It's not impossible, but like if I really, if you can maybe see, so you can kind of see through it. That won't happen if you have your page covered with matte medium. It coats the page, and it gives it a little more tooth, but I'll just have to go a little thicker. Okay, so I'm just going to have to put a little thicker coat, maybe two coats, to cover up the blue because of the slickness of the page. So if you cover it with a matte medium, you will not have to worry about that. You can just cover things easier. I think I'm going to get rid of that mountain too. But this is how you can start with the page. And again, see how the mountain's still see-through? You have to put two coats on. If I had the matte medium on here, that would have covered in one coat. So, but two coats of paint's no big deal. And sometimes where the words are, that may take two coats as well. But this is just kind of how I start. And there's no particular colors or just what you like. You know, I have my favorite colors that I like. So while that's just sitting, it'll take just dry in a second. I could come on this side and do this side. Just make sure if you get in the crevice here that you really dry that before you close your book, because that's where you have the trouble. If you varnish, matte medium, or paint in the crevice of your book and it's not dry, then you close the book and you go to open it, it's going to peel a layer off there. I think I'm going to get rid of all this. And I'm just showing you how you can't, don't be afraid to get rid of anything. That's why it's, I just call it like reverse collage, because I'm getting rid of stuff. Okay. So, yeah. Just do that. And if it's not drying fast enough for you, then just take your heat gun and, you know. Okay, am I not plugged in? I think I unplugged myself. Hang on, my heat gun better not have died. My 25-year-old heat gun. Wait, I think I'm just unplugged. Hang on, let me follow the trail here. Where's my heat gun? Let's see, guys. Oh, I think, guys, may it rest in peace. I hear the motor trying. There it goes. It's. I think it's on its last leg, guys. It's 25 years old. Uh-oh, I hear it trying. It's on its last leg, Paula! Persimmon. This is persimmon. I'm afraid to turn it off. Me and Paula have had those heat guns for 25 years. I know. It's still starting, but I can hear it inside going click, 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 click. I'm going to have to get it. And it was just so funny. We were just talking about that the other day. I have to have a heat gun. I mean, this one, I mean, the fact that it's lasted this long is really amazing. It catch on fire. I hope not, Vicky. So I'm just putting another second coat on here. I know, Paula's going, oh my God, no! But they're the best. They've lasted forever. It's the Marvy Uchida. And I think, I mean, no joke, I think it's 25 years old. So, hey, I can't complain. That looks kind of cool like that. It almost looks like, I think I'm going to leave that side. See how it looks like, almost like a negative photograph? Let's see, I might get a little bit up here, but yeah. I'm going to leave that. I think that looks kind of cool. I know, jeans did melt on her. It wasn't a Marvy Chica, though. She had a different brand. You have the same one, Janet? Janice, is yours still going? All right, so now the bottom here, I'm going to want to do, I'm not sure if I want water, stars, a combination. I kind of like this little bit of, it's not corrugate, well, it's steel corrugate. It's not cardboard corrugate. You like that shadowing too? Yeah, I'm going to leave that. But down here now, and I think I'm almost out of this uniform blue. It's a nice gray blue. I use it so much. So I'm going to just put a little of that out. I'm going to put a little bit of baby blue out. I'm going to put a little bit of white. And I'll show you all this technique. Let me get a baby wipe to clean my hands off, though. Baby wipe's my favorite blending tool, too. I think I've said that a few times. All right. Office Depot has it for $30, the Marvy Cheetah. Really, Suzanne? I don't have an Office Depot. I have a Staples. I think I have Office Max and Office, yeah, I think they combine. I'll have to go look at mine. Mine's over there by Walmart, I think. I never go to it because I have Staples Rewards, so I really never go to Office Max or Office Depot. But, yeah, I will for a Marvy Uchida. Okay, so now, down here on the bottom, I'm going to take a palette knife, just a plastic palette knife, and I'm going to, like, just pick up. See how there's two blues on there? Okay. And I'm going to scrape. I might pick up a little white. So what I'm going to do, and I'm going to just kind of go right over the top of these. It's a little tricky inside the little, you know, inside the ditch. You might have to get a paintbrush or get in there. But I'm going to, that's too far up. I just want to scrape up some of this. So I'm trying to keep it kind of marbly looking. Can y'all see that? I don't want to over mix. I want it to be very, look, there you go. See that? And you don't have to cover it completely because the background will be, you know, just give it more like texture look. But this is the kind of stuff you can do in your altered book. See how cool that looks? I think that's almost enough. Let's do a little bit more splashes. Too far up here. Okay, so what I'm going to do, just get a few more little, this, and I'm not going to even work on this page. This is just a little sample for you. Okay, now what I'm going to do is get a little bit of, water this down a little. Where's my water? Oh. I'm going to water down this white and get a fluffy brush. Here's white. Oh. Okay, so I'm going to water that down. I might need a little bit more. Whoop, there it goes. Splattering it myself. There might be a planet right there at the end. Yeah, I like it just peeking through too. So I'm going to water down this white, and then I'm going to tap out some. So this is all I'm going to do on this page for now. But I just wanted to show you how you can take paint and block out areas. And if you don't want any where it's gone, you need to get it while it's wet, unless you can use your matte medium. If you've matte medium stuff, that's another advantage of the matte medium. You can get them on Amazon too. Thanks, Beth. With matte medium, you could. Okay, I'm going to smear that back up and get some off. Sorry, I'm three tracks at a time here in my head. If it's matte medium, a baby wipe will take off, you know, you can blend and mix with your baby wipe. Oh, thanks, Beth. Okay. Jean, yeah, there you go, Jean. Make her call for a doctor appointment before she streams, right? All right, so let me move these out of the way, and let's see if I can get my heat gun going. Let's see what we can do here, guys. I just have to pat it and be gentle. Come on, you can do it! And the dots that I flicked, they're going to take a little longer to dry because it's a little thicker, you know, even though I watered it down. So what I want to do, before I close this is put a piece of wax paper in between just to make sure, because some of these dots are not going to be dry, and I don't want to stick my book together. You can follow through. I tried three rabbit trails. I can't do many more than that, though, Meowcat. Okay. Yeah. Well, I don't think they're going to replace my 25-year-old heat gun, Jean. It's like, really, people? All right, so now I'm going to go back over here. Paula's going to go make a phone call or two, and we're going to, you know, wrap this up in probably about 30 minutes. That'll get us an hour and a half stream. We'll see how far we get in an hour and a half. Or whenever she gets off the phone. All right, so now I'm going to put some more wax paper behind these pages here. Okay. And this is all provided my heat gun continues to work. If the heat gun fails, we're done. Because I have to have a heat gun. I'm not going to sit here and dry for hours with a, you know, what do you call it, a hair dryer. All right, so this is what I have planned as far as these elements. I'm going to have some stars up here, but I just put this here to kind of remind me. I will use this one, but I'm going to paint out all of this. Yeah, that's a bit too much ass, Jean. No, it's not smelling at all, Sherry. My heat gun is not smelling at all. I think the motor's just about gone. I hate to say it, but yeah. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do, and let me show y'all this. I put my golden matte medium in a dish soap jar, and it's almost out. I might have to actually fill it. I'm going to get a dry palette here, and because that way you can squeeze out what you want as long as you don't let the cap dry. This one's a couple years old. Well, probably more than that. Carol, Sunset Carol told me about this tip. But this is almost empty. I need to refill it anyway, so I'm going to set it aside, and I'm going to go ahead and get in my jar here and pour some out. I put a baggie over the top because that protects, it makes it so it doesn't glue your lid shut. So I'm just going to pour some out. Whoa, that's probably plenty. And then put the baggie back on top. So that way you will not glue your lid shut. Some people put some Vaseline on it and different things. To me, it's just as easy to do this. All right, so now I got my brushes that are designated just glue brushes. They're in water. They're the only brushes I leave in water. And they're crusty, rusty, and nasty. Probably don't need that there. That's probably not a good idea. Let me move it. I just thought of something there. I don't like that there. Too close to Lappy since I moved the room around. Okay, so, and then a card to scrape everything down with. You know, a gift card, whatever, you know, an Apple card, whatever. But tons of them. All right. So what I'm going to do is, again, I just tack this down And I knew it was going to, you know, peel up because that's where it's going to go. So it doesn't matter. You can put less or more glue. So I'm going to just get it all. And again, even though I'm not gluing anything down here, get a little excess water out. Even though I'm not going to glue anything down here, just to get rid of the shine. And then I put it on the back. And then I also put it over the top. Then I take my card and just scrape it all down. This will get out any air bubbles or wrinkles, okay? Something like that. I do need a couple baby wipes, though. Okay, so let's get crack-a-lack in here. And you can just lift it up if you want and just paint under it or and over it, as long as you just get it glued down. Just whatever's the easiest. Just make sure you put wax paper, because otherwise you're going to glue your book shut. Okay, so I'm going to do this. Get it on the backs. Just glue it down. And I put a lot. I slather this thing down with glue, because I want to make sure it stays down. But you can peel them back up, depending on how much you tack them down. So I'm just going to scrape these down. Like that, and that side's glued. Okay, same thing for over here. I'm going to try to pick this one up, though, because there's quite a bit. All right. And I like to put it on the substrate, on the back, and over the top. I like to put a lot. That's just me, because I don't want it to move at all. Okay, so I'm going to come down here. You can take it all apart. I'm trying to be a little quick. Okay, let me smear this side down, or smash this side down. Like that. If you have any questions, put them in caps, because I'm rolling here, people. Rolling. Everybody, for being here today while we just do a little bit in this abandoned book. All right, so now I'm done with my. I'm going to put this in the water. It's the only brushes I leave in water are my glue brushes. And then this one's starting to get a little crusty, so I'll just throw that away because I got tons of cards. All right, here we go now. Heat gun time. Let's hope it continues to work. It could be the switch, the switch, maybe, I don't know, that switch is, do you think? You think there could be a little something stopping that switch? Night, Ozzy, thanks for being here. Let's, here we go. It took three tries to get it on. Yeah. You like watching me working this book? Okay. Aw, thanks, Button Attic. I'm the best wake up. I love Mondays. I love my Monday mornings. Uh-oh, you know what I did? I put the pages between the wrong two pages. I hope I didn't glue that shut. I know. It's an old friend. I mean, you have it for so many years, right? All right, so let me put my wax paper between the correct pages. We don't glue that together. This one's okay. All right, so now we're going to do the paint. Again, I'm going to use these colors because I got those colors, but I'm also going to need black and some yellow ochre. Okay, so let's see. And I may need some other colors too. All right, so this is where I usually do a lot of finger painting just to get it base coated down. So I'm going to put some black. Now my white, that's all watered down. So if I need more white, I'm going to have to get some more white out. And then this is spicy mustard. And there's not much left in there. But yellow ochre, spicy mustard, you know. I don't really look at the names unless y'all ask me what they are, because I'm going by the color. And then I do need a little bit more. I think I'm going to go back to just a tiny bit of the persimmon. So we're going to go with those colors. The baby blue, the uniform blue, the persimmon, spicy mustard, black, and maybe some white here in a minute. I don't know. I thought it was a Marvy Uchida. I mean, I can't really see the copy, you know, the information there. It's really crusted over. Okay, so first off, I'm going to start with the sky. And let's go ahead and get the black here. And I'm going to do a lot of finger painting here. It's quick. Quick. So I think I might have the sky turn into a blue. Do I want it in a mustard color? Let's see. Let's get this side done. Now, if I want to keep anything, like let's say I wanted to keep these buildings right here, then I'd have to paint that because my finger's not going to, you know, fit in there. But I'm going to kind of get rid of all that. I think I might get the trees. I think I will make those trees come up into the space. So I'm going to leave the bulk of the, or the trunks of the trees there. And then I'll just get rid of all this and I'll paint in my own trees. Now, how far do I want this building to come down? Yes, it is a crusty one. All right. So. Because this is all going to be planets, stars, and all that I'm going to put in myself. I'll paint in my own planets. Like, for instance, I'll take a couple blues. Here, let's see where I want one. Maybe one right here. Paint one in here. There'll be one right back in there somewhere. I really need to let that black dry, but we'll have something back in there. Okay, so back to, did Paula get her appointment set? Curious minds want to know. All right. So now I think, though, I want, if I have black behind this, it's going to be too, we're going to lose that building. So I think I'm going to go with the blues. Let me get some of the black off my hand here. You have that persimmon on your list? Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and get some of the blue. And I'm just going to, so I can get like right up to the building. Even though I'm going to have some fog and mist coming across it. Let me just get it blocked in because my finger, you know, is not that sharp. And I'm going to have a little, I think I'll have a little, let me just put this in one. I think I'm going to have a little path coming up there. We'll have a path coming up there and maybe another path right there. Maybe two paths. All right, let's get back to this. So I'm just going to block this in. And then we'll smear it together. Waiting to see on. Make sure Paula's off the phone. Because I'm going to do this quick, guys. We're going to wrap this baby up. I want to see Paula's watercolors. Is that terrible? I'm cutting my stream short because I want to go be enabled. Is that bad? It's actually, while you have the wax paper, you can just go right off the edge. All right, so right along that edge there. All right, let me go back in here now with my fingers. All right, so can you kind of see how, look how quick that was. Okay, Jessica, good to see you. I know, finger painting's not for everybody. All right, now I'll take my baby wipe and get in there. I missed something Paula said on Wednesday. You are streaming on Wednesday night. So does that mean you're not going to show your watercolors? Say it isn't so. All right, now I'm going to get my watered down white real quick here. See how quick that is, guys? I mean, seriously, that's pretty quick. All right, so let's go across here. And what I want to do now, I'm going to dry that, and then I'm going to put some mist across here, too. This is just laid in there for now. She was looking at me when she said that. Oh, oh, good, Jean. Thank you. All right, here we go. Let's see what happens. Yes, I have. I've done a color book page with crayons. Just Crayola crayons. Well, I hope y'all enjoyed a little bit of demo with some collage and mixed media in our abandoned book. This may be water coming. I think I might make this water and that a path. Okay, so before I put some fog and mist on that, let me go ahead and do down here. So I got my persimmon and my mustard color here. And here's where we're just going to start. The details where I'm going to draw the trees, we'll hopefully get to that. We'll see. We'll see what we do here. So I'm going to do a couple different colors. I'm just picking up two colors at a time just to see. I didn't quite glue that down right there. Just to get this covered. And I'm going to go on with another layer of blue. It's pretty thick, guys. When I do this, I mean, I'm picking up, there's a lot of paint. That's quite a bit of paint. So that you can just like, it just flows. Right? It just flows across when it's thick like that. But it does take a minute to dry when you do that. And you want to keep your wax paper behind it too. I'm just watching for any chat. Comments. All right, so first I'm just going to finish this all the way across here. See how fun this is? I mean, I love doing this. It's just fun to me. It's like finger painting when you're in kindergarten. But you can't be, here's the thing, if you're working in one of your altered books, like, you can't be afraid. You can't be afraid, oh my God, I'm going to mess it up. If you're afraid, you won't just slap it on like this, guys. And that's what makes it so cool, is the no fear. Okay, so now I'm going to get in here with the two blues. I think I might need maybe I'll pick up a little white. All right, so I'm going to kind of come across here. I'm going to have a little, I'll say a pond or something, but it's a little tricky in the center there. I do need a little bit more baby blue. Thanks, Terry. Yeah. All right, so I'm just going to... It's thick, guys. The reason you can do this is because the paint's really thick. if you try to do this thin, you're not going to get that drag across look, you know? If you try to do it real thin, it won't give you that textury look like this. It's because it's thick I can do this. Okay. All right, I'll just carry a little bit over here, a little of the dark blue under here, and off the edges. Same for right there. Got a little bit of collage tear. Need to kind of blend that. Alright, so now I'm going to take and I'm going to kind of decide how I want this to wave out here. Thanks, Samurai. Okay, so I'm going to want it to come down this way. Kind of across here, maybe. A little bit of water coming right across this little street. Because I'm going to have those trees. I'm going to actually paint in those trees. Something like that. I might put some weeds here, but I want some water. So let's see. Let me get a little bit more white paint because that's all watered down. And a dry brush. All right, so now I'm going to do, I think I'm going to have some water come down here. Maybe it'll flow a couple ways down this hill. And this is where you start playing with your details. It's a little thick. I think I need a little bit of orange back. And a little bit of blue, I think. It's just got too wide of a river. I don't want it that wide. I want it a little subtle. Need some tiny lines. I'll have to get my thin brush or a Posca, I think. All right, now over here, I think I want this to be a misty path coming out of here. So I'll mist that up. Okay, so I'm going to stop on that because I want this to be quick. Let's just hope the heat gun continues to work. I'll do two more quick things and then we're going to be done. Okay, so the last couple things I want to do is I want my Posca. Where is that? Here. I want these trees. I'm going to do, and I probably won't take the time to do it all right this second, because I want Paula's Street. Sorry, I'm being selfish. I want to watch Paula's Street. So, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to make these come all the way up. And this takes a little bit if you want to do it right. You can't really just rush every little branch here. You really kind of want to take your time so that it looks like real branches. And, you know, it take a few minutes here. Because I want to do it on this one. I want to do it on this one. And if it's too white, remember I told you guys, if when you do something with the Posca and it's too white, go back over it with a pencil and knock it back. Knock the color back. So you can see how we're going here. Know what I mean, Vern? And I'll just continue to work on this because I don't want to rush the little stems here, or the little branches, rather. You like it? Thanks, Miss Vicky B. Vicky BR. Alligator Vicky. Okay, so I'll just keep on. I'm going to do more on those branches. But I just want you to kind of see where we're headed, right? Do little tiny ones and details. But what I want to show you before we leave is the fog and mist. So let me dry this real quick. Welcome back, Janet. So I might want to do... Here we go. I know I'm bumping everything. I'm looking for a blue pencil. Here we go. Maybe a blue and an orange. Let's see, where's my orange? Okay, and I know I love these same colors all the time. So I might want to do a couple extra planets. I might want to do a little bit of, you know, space debris and stuff going on. Can do a little bit of all this, you know, as your detail. Just a couple of pencils. But what I want to show you now is I'm going to take a wet baby wipe. This is the last. This is all I'm going to show you, and then we're leaving, so get ready. All right, so now I'm going to take my baby wipe. And this is how, somebody asked me how I get mist or fog. I put it on my baby wipe and kind of smoosh it into the baby wipe. Okay, you don't have to put it on your hand, but then you can see how much is going on. So I'm putting it on my hand and on the baby wipe and mushing it into the baby wipe. And you can see how thick you got it. If it's too much, then you need to kind of, you know, wipe it back so you don't have too much on your baby wipe. All right, so what I want to do, though, is I want, it looks like a little much. I want to mist and fog over this. Okay? And the easiest way for me to get that look is this right here. It's a little tricky right in the thing there. You have to sometimes work. You might even have to get a brush in there. Because it's a little tricky in the ditch of a book. Okay? And that's how you can get that misty look like that, is with a baby wipe. And I use Huggies. Huggies Natural. Don't get the ones, the aloe or the soap or any of that, because then it's all squishy with soap. Okay? You don't want that. Bye, Trina. Thanks again for the happy mail. Okay? Maybe there's a little bit more back behind that building. And then I'm going to want it right here. So now I'm going to do the same thing. This is where the fog and mist is coming out of there. Maybe you could kind of roll it in. And maybe there's some down in here. And you could get some more little detail. You could do, you know, little individual little swirls here. I do that with pencil, I think. I'll try to do that in a minute. Maybe just fix my water here just a little. So, yeah. So this is kind of just how I do the... So any questions, guys? mean, could there be some, you know, see, it's kind of like watering their land, and you got to kind of play with it and get it how you want, because then you got your streets up there. And so, yeah, I'm going to call that done for now anyway. We could always go back in there and add stuff. Oh, yeah, we didn't add much in the, let me add a little glow around the, let's make sure that's dry. Need to make it round now. Let me move my wax paper out of everything. And so you can kind of see where we're going. Oh, over here. Let's make sure that's dry. You could add some little, let's add some little swirls of mist, maybe behind here. Very subtle, but you know, just a little. So I hope y'all liked it. And we're going to go over to Paula's. I am anyway. Is that terrible? Let me just add a couple little extra bright. There we go. So, oh, splattered something there. Let's get that off. So, again, I will work on the trees, you know, some of the branches, and fade them out a little with a pencil, because I want them to look like they're all the way up into space here. So I'll play with those. I'll post a picture in a little bit, guys. And I will upload these videos after a while. Thanks, guys. I'm glad y'all enjoyed it. Hopefully you got some ideas for an altered book page. And again, pick books. Pick a book that you're going to like the theme of. Don't just pick a, you know, abandoned place and then you're not going to like doing abandoned places. Pick a garden, a, you know, whatever it is you like. All right. Thanks, guys, for being here. I'm going to go. Janet, please tweet that out if you do. If you stream with Jen tonight, please. Please, please, please. And we're giving Janet lots of hugs today. All right, guys. Love you guys. Have a good one. Bye-bye.